Hey everybody, welcome to my new video series, How I Built the Craziest Gym Ever. This series will include several episodes carefully explaining each piece of equipment I've built in my home gym. I'll be sure to cover things like a list of materials used for each machine, a basic cut list, the dimensions of each machine, and general instruction on how to assemble each piece of equipment. I'll also be adding what tools were used, how much time and cost, as well as discussing future gym equipment projects. If you enjoy this video and want to support future content, be sure to subscribe and leave a comment down below. So without further delay, let's get to this episode's project. Hey everybody, welcome back to Powerborn Productions. Today we're going to go over how to build your own adjustable weight bench. A lot of people who watch my channel enjoy the convenience of training at home, and one of the more useful pieces of equipment I would suggest having is a multi-purpose adjustable bench. This bench allows you to train several different exercises at various angles in order to target specific muscle groups you wish to improve through resistance training. It's affordable, easy to make, and best of all, it provides countless new exercises to your routine that you may not otherwise have. Here are the steps needed to build this adjustable weight bench. Step 1. Gather all necessary materials. Starting with the wooden materials first, you will need 1 8-foot 4x4, 1 48-inch by 24-inch by 3/4-inch sheet of plywood, and 2 8-foot 2x2s. For the hardware, you will need 16 Simpson strong ties, 2 10mm pillow blocks, 2 4-inch by 3/8-inch hex bolt and nut, 1 8-inch by 1/2-inch hex bolt and nut, 1 10-inch by 1/2-inch hex bolt and 3 nuts, and 1 box of 3-inch screws and a handful of 2-inch screws. For the upholstery, you will need 2 yards of vinyl fabric and 2 yards of 2-inch foam padding. For the tools, you will need 1 circular saw, a miter saw and table saw were also used in this project, but not necessary. 1 power drill with appropriate drill bits. 1 staple gun with staples. And last but not least, sanding equipment. Step 2, complete cut list. Starting with the 4x4 first, make the following cuts. 1 cut of 45 inches, 2 cuts of 14 inches, and 2 cuts of 11 1/2 inches. For the 3/4-inch plywood, you will need 1 cut of 14 inches by 14 inches, and 1 cut of 34 inches by 14 inches. And for the 8-foot 2x2s, you will need 2 cuts of 30 inches, 2 cuts of 16 inches, and 2 cuts of 10 1/2 inches. Step 3, sand each board. It's important to remember you will be actively handling and maneuvering this bench around in your gym, so be sure to take your time and sand each board from the cut list to avoid splinters and to make it as user-friendly as possible. Step 4, assemble legs and frame. Now it's time to start the assembly process. Begin by taking the 45-inch 4x4 board from the cut list and lay it down on the ground. Then take the 2 11 1/2-inch 4x4 boards and place them 2 1/2 inches from each end of the 45-inch board as shown. Join the boards together by using the Simpson strong ties and 3-inch screws. Be sure to bend 4 of the strong ties to 90 degrees by hand before installing accordingly. Now take the remaining 14-inch 4x4 boards from the cut list and place them on top of the 11 1/2-inch boards as shown. Measure and mark the boards at 7 inches to be sure it is placed evenly before joining it together, leaving 5 1/4 inches on both sides of the board. Once again, join the boards together using the Simpson strong ties and 3-inch screws to complete the frame of the bench. The last part of this step is to turn the frame over and verify the frame is both solid and stable. Step 5, install seat pad. Installing the seat is fairly simple. Take the 2 10 1/2-inch 2x2 boards from the cut list and join them to both sides of the frame as shown using 3-inch screws. Be sure both boards are flush with the 4x4 before joining them to the frame. This will provide a larger surface area for the seat to join to. Next, take the 14-inch by 14-inch plywood from the cut list and place it on top of the bench frames. Position the plywood so that 3 3/4 inches can be measured from the frame to either side of the plywood and 3 inches to the front of the plywood as shown. Once in place, join the plywood to the frame using both 2-inch and 3-inch screws. Step 6, assemble adjustable pad. Start by taking the remaining 34-inch plywood board from the cut list and place it on the ground. Then take the two 30-inch 2x2 boards and place them on top of the plywood. Drill a 1/2-inch hole 2 inches from the end of both boards and position them so that it measures 3 3/4 inches from either side of the plywood and 3 1/2 inches between the 2x2s as shown. Once measured, join both 2x2s to the plywood using 2-inch screws. The next part of this step is to install the two pillow blocks from the hardware list. Measure 16 1/2 inches from the end of the 2x2s and join the pillow blocks to the outside surface of the 2x2 board as seen here using 2-inch screws. Next, take the remaining 16-inch 2x2 boards from the cut list and drill a hole 1 inch from each end of both boards. Make one hole big enough to fit the 3/8 hex bolt from the hardware list and the other big enough to fit the 1/2-inch hex bolt. Now slide the 10-inch by 1/2-inch hex bolt into the appropriate hole and insert one of the 3 1/2-inch nuts so the 2x2 is locked into position. Insert the second 1/2-inch nut about 2 inches from the end of the hex bolt as shown. Next, insert the second 16-inch 2x2 so that it's flush with the second hex nut before inserting the third and final 1/2-inch nut onto the hex bolt to secure the second 2x2 board in place. The final part of step 6 is to take the two 4-inch by 3/8-inch hex bolts and slide them through the inside of the pillow blocks and into the smaller holes of the 2x2. Then insert the appropriate hex nut as you see here to create a hinge support. Make sure the hinge support can easily swing back and forth and be certain the hex bolt on the hinge support comes to a rest at a suitable position. Step 7, install adjustable pad. Before installing the adjustable part of the bench, you must measure and drill one last hole. Turn the bench over on its side and measure 13 inches from the end of the frame and 1 inch down from the top of the frame. Drill a 1/2-inch hole using a power drill and turn the frame back to an upright position. Now place the adjustable bench on top of the frame and position the holes in the 2x2 to match the holes in the frame. Use the remaining 10-inch hex bolt from the hardware list and slide it through the holes in the bench and frame and secure it together with a 1/2-inch hex nut and washer. Once complete, the bench should be able to rise from a flat position into a 90-degree upright position without hesitations. You may need to tighten or loosen some of the bolts accordingly. The last part of this step is to measure and cut the preset positions you would like the bench to have. Using a tape measure, measure and mark the amount of incline you would like the bench to sit at. The first mark should be at 3 inches to 5 inches to leave plenty of room for the hex bolt to sit when the bench is in its flattest position. The next marks are at 11 inches for a mild incline, 18 1/2 inches for a steep incline, and 25 1/2 inches for a 90-degree angle for when you want to train shoulders. Once all positions are marked, it's now time to cut slots into the frame using a circular saw. Be sure to set the saw cutting depth to 3/4 inch and make each slot about 1/2 inch in width to be sure the hex bolt on the hinge support can easily fit into position. When you're finished cutting the slots, be sure to test each position accordingly to ensure a perfect fit, making adjustments where needed. Step 8, upholster bench. The last step of this project is to simply upholster the bench to your liking. Start by cutting the 2-inch foam padding to match the dimensions of the plywood. Use strips of duct tape to wrap around the foam to hold it into place. Then measure and cut the vinyl fabric to the appropriate length. Be sure to add 2 inches to all the measurements of the fabric to account for the padding and ensure a tight fit. The final part of this step is to carefully stretch and staple the vinyl fabric to the plywood using a staple gun. Now that everything is complete, be sure to test the bench out extensively to make sure the padding is sufficient in all the right areas and everything fits into position as it should. I chose to use additional padding for the front of the seat to help prevent me from sliding out of position when in use. Now for time and cost. This project is estimated to cost somewhere between $80 and $90, with labor time estimated to be about 3 hours. You have now completed your multi-purpose adjustable bench. Be sure to follow along as we continue the series, How I Built the Craziest Gym Ever.